Hi guys, I welcome you all to Rodha. Okay, my name is Ray Prakash, and so in this CAT 2020 series, okay, so this is a new kind of sets which we're going to discuss actually. Okay, that is called crypt arithmetic LRDI sets. Okay, so crypt arithmetic LRDI sets, right? So basically, we write the name here, crypt arithmetic. Fine. So see, in the last three four years of CAT, right? So couple of times they have asked sets on crypt arithmetic. Okay, so it's actually in the recent trend now. Okay, so you'll see a lot of such sets in mocks also, right? So basically, so what do you mean by crypt arithmetic LRDI sets? Right? Basically, crypt arithmetic basically means that this crypt arithmetic basically represents for letters and numbers, right? So basically, we have letters actually, okay, and they are represented by corresponding digits, right? So not exactly as you think, is like A to Z is 1 to 26. So basically here the letters are basically in the form of digits. They are from 0 to 9. Okay. And then we just try to move on these questions, right? Okay. So basically, let me brief you about how to attack basically crypt arithmetic LRDI sets, right? So how to attack crypt arithmetic LRDI sets. Okay, so just have a look at few points here, guys. Okay, then we can see one or two very good set on LRDI set on this crypt arithmetic, and there's one CAT question also in CAT 2019. Okay, so that also we'll discuss here, right? So how to attack crypt arithmetic LRDI sets. Okay, now see guys, so basically a few attacking points here are, so we look for repetition. Okay, we look for repetition of letters actually. Okay, that's one good point to look at. Okay, other good point to look at is actually if once the letters are repeating, it is addition or it is multiplication, right? So what kind of pattern actually brings on this letter repetition, right? For example, I would say let's say y into y, okay, is equal to some y only. Okay, so if we have y into y is equal to y, now tell me y represents a digit, right? So y represents a digit from 0 to 9. Now tell me which digits this y can take actually. Okay, so obviously y can take value 0 into 0. Okay, y can take value 1 into 1 is also 1. Y can take value 5 into 5 is 25, so ending in 5. 6 into 6 is 36, so ending in 6, right? So basically, y can take, if we have a statement here that y into y is equal to y, so we can infer from here, if we can infer here that y is equal to 0 or 1 or 5 or 6. Correct, right? Okay. Now similarly, if we go on here and let's say we have one more statement like this, let's say it's given that a into b is equal to a. Right. Now tell you what are the possibilities, guys. Okay. So the possibilities here can be, if A into B is equal to A, so we can have different possibilities here. Those possibilities can be, let's say for example, A can be even or odd, right? So I can say that, let's say A can be a multiple of 5. Hai na? That's 5 into 3 will be equal to 15. So ending in again 5. 5 and 5 same. Correct. 5 into 7 is 35. So again ending in 5. Again 5 and 5 same. 5 into 9 is 45, right? So again, 5, this 5 and 5 are same. Okay, this kind of numbers it can have, or it can go to even numbers also, right? In even numbers, we can have, like, for example, 2 into 6. So 2 into 6 is equal to 12, so ending in 2. 2 into, not 2, actually 4 into 6, right? So basically 4 into 6 can end in 24, that is 4 and 4 is basically 2 and 2 here. Okay, then we can have 8 into 6 as 48, right? So 8 and 6 is 48, right? Okay, so basically again 8 and 8 being same here, right? So basically these are the kind of attacking points which we have to look at the start. Okay, so from where it is starting, which are the latest repetition, right? And then we can probably focus after this point, we can probably focus on addition and subtractions also. Okay, so this is basically the kind of questions which are looking at, including addition, subtraction, okay, could be multiplication, could be division, right? So this kind of questions may come in CAT, right? So CAT has basically asked till now a set on addition, right? Okay. And a normal set, basically it's a puzzle forming set, right? Okay. Now see guys, now if I try to actually take one example here, right? So let me take a very good LRDA set on this. Okay. So for example, let's say we have a LRDA set actually. Okay. And we can actually think how to, we can see how to approach the set, right? Yes, see. This is the LRDA set actually. Okay. So we have an LRDA set for this. Okay, fine. See guys, the set is actually, we have got R, P, B here. Okay. And we have got U, S, E, R, S. Okay. And then we have got R and B here. And then we have got B, R, S, R. Okay. Then after that, we have got this P, R, D, S. And then we have got P, T, C, B. Then we have got B, B, R. Correct. So this is basically RB is the quotient here. BB is the remainder here in this division. Okay. So basically it is written here that all letters represents distinct digits from 0 to 9. Okay. And we have four questions to follow here. So those four questions could be, let's say my first question could be, what is the value of R plus B? My second question could be, what is the value of U plus S? My third question could be, what is the value of, let's say, D plus T? Okay. And my fourth question could be, what is the value of, let's say, E plus, or let's say, E into P? Okay. So basically, the questions will be like such that you have to calculate the value of every digit here. Okay. So now see guys, so once we see this kind of set, okay, so just you can just pause this video here and try this set for at least 15 minutes, right? Try karo at least 15 minutes, right? And then we can have the funda here. What we can actually see here is, okay, so how basically it is solved. Okay. So now see, what is the attacking point here, right? What are the attacking points here? Okay. So basically, so for solving such sets, what we should actually do, because division is always made up of, okay guys, division is always made up of multiplication and subtraction, hai na? So division is always made up of multiplication and subtraction, right? Basically, so we should break division into two parts. One is multiplication and one is subtraction. Okay, now how it is multiplied, dekho, like RPB into R should give you BRSR, hai na? So let me write here that RPB, okay, into R is giving me how much? Let's say it is giving me BRSR here, right? So let me write here BRSR. Okay, fine. One more multiplication, guys. One more is basically RPB into B, that second row, right? So RPB into B should give me PTCB. So RPB, okay. Right, R P B into this B actually, right? Okay, so R P B into B should give me P T C B. Okay, and we have got one subtraction here, right? So we have got basically two subtractions here. Okay, like use U S E R minus B R S R is giving me P R D S, right? And then P R D S minus P T C B is giving P B B R, right? So if the things goes complex, right? If the things goes complex, we can actually take out these numbers also, because sometimes the set can be tough, sometimes it can be easy, right? So we don't know actually. It's a moderate level set actually. Okay, fine. So if needed, we can take out this also. Okay, if needed, I'm telling you, if needed, you can just take out this also, right? Like U S E R minus B R S R, and just write it, right? What is P R D S actually? Okay, but this is not needed, I think, or if it is needed, right? If it is needed, we can write later on actually. Okay, so we can start with these two hints actually, because I see here lot of letters being repeated. What I'm actually trying to find here, lot of letters being repeated actually, right? And I can see here that lot of letters are repeated. B, B and B, B, R and R, right? Okay, R and R. So lot of repetition are there. So I may not need those two further subtractions actually. Okay. So now what I'll actually do in this case now, I'll just try to figure out these two multiplication, right? If there were no repetitions here, right? Or very less kind of repetition, that means we have got very less clues. less repetition means less clues, right? So if we had got less clues, then we would have going down to get right four steps here, two for the subtractions also. Okay, USER minus BRSR, so those two are also the clues for me, right? But okay, so this is already a lot of repetition here, so I may not need it, right? Okay, chalo, let's solve it, guys. Now see, so now if I go with the clues here, right? Basically, B into B is B. That's my major clue, na? Okay. That B into B is B here. So, B into B is B. Right? Now, tell me, guys, if B into B is B, when it is true? When it is true? We just discussed, right? It is true for B equal to 0, or B is equal to 1, or B is equal to 5, or B is equal to 6. Guys, among these numbers, I think 0 will not occur. Because, why 0 will not occur? Because if this B is 0, then whole thing becomes 0. Where it is written that all letters represent distinct digits. Okay, that is not possible. Okay, B equal to 1 is also not possible. Because if B is 1, then RPB into 1 should be RPB only. Anything multiplied by 1 should be that thing only, right? So that means B is not 1 also. Okay then. Can B be 5 here? Okay, yes, B can be 5 here. Okay, B can be 5 as well as B can be 6. So we have got two possibilities that B can be 5 or 6, right? So we see here that we have one more clue for B actually, that B into R is equal to R. If we latch on this clue actually, so just see guys. So now B into R is R. Okay, just try to see this guys. B into R is equal to R. Now tell me guys, B have got only two possibilities. B has got only two possibilities, 5 or 6, right? Tell me, is B 5 possible now? Because if B is 5, then 5 multiplied by any number will not give you same letter actually. Or same digit. Or if I multiply 5 by some odd number, then I'm supposed to get 5 here only. That means B should have repeated. Right? So if B is 5, then B should have repeated. Okay. But here actually R is repeating. That means B 5 case is also gone. Right? Now I'm sure that B is equal to 6. So when B is equal to 6, you can just replace this 6 with everywhere where B is 6, right? So let's replace B with 6, 6, 6 is 36, ka 6, carry will be 3 here. Okay, now again, now B is 6, yes, B is 6 and B is 6, fine. Acha, okay. Now we can have R also here. Okay, so if B, now tell me guys, if B is equal to 6, so if B is equal to 6, what can be the value of R actually? Okay, so now I think about R actually, right? Okay, let's go. R ke liye what clue I have got here? See guys, now if you see here that R into R, okay, dhyan dena, R into R will be equal to R. So this R into B is something this R, R into P is something this S, right? Now R into R is already 6 here and it should be a 2-digit number, right? So R into R is a 2-digit number, right? So when R into R will be a 2-digit number, right? Tell me at what value, and already you know that if B is equal to 6, it actually repeats only when if R is 8, if R is 2, sorry, if other is 8, if 2 or 4, right? We have just seen this in the last slide actually. Hana? So among these 8, 2 and 4 is the possibility, guys, tell me. So 6 already means this number has to be in 60s. If it has to be in 60s, so 8 into 8 is 64, right? So only there's a possibility, right? There's no other possibility because already we have a 6 here. So 8 into 8 will be 64. That means for sure R has to be equal to 8. Right. So we have got two great things here. Okay. So we have got B is equal to 6. That's the fixed value. R is equal to 8. We have got a fixed value. I'm going to replace with this R 8 everywhere. Okay. So now R 8 into 8 is, guys, 8 into 8 is 64. Okay. But I cannot write 60. P here. I need to search for P also. So 8 into 8 is 64, but here if R is 8, this should be 68. Now tell me, again one more clue here. If 8 into 8 is 64 and we have 68 here, that means we are generating a carry of 4. Okay, so that means from here to here, we are generating a carry of plus 4. If we are generating a carry of plus 4, now tell me 8 into P, at what value of P? Think over it, guys, right? Think over it. Take care. LID is very interesting. Okay. Just think over it, right? 8 into P is generating a carry of 4. Okay, what value of P it will generate a carry of 4? So because 8 into P should end in 40s. If the number will end in 40s, then we'll write the last digit and the carry will be 4. Correct. So now 8 into p, right? So basically 8 into p, so p should be what? P should be equal to 5. So p should be equal to 5. So 8 into 5 is 40. 40 plus 4 is 40. Sorry, 40, right? And what we did initially? So 8 into 6 is 48. 48, 8 we have written here. The carry initially was 4. So when the carry initially was 4, so 8 into 6 is 48. Sorry, 8 into 6 is 48. 8 carries 4. 8 into 5 is 40. 40 plus 4 is 44. So S will be equal to 4. 44, 4s will come, 4 will come here. Then again 4 is carry. 8 into 8 is 64 plus 4 is 68, right? 6, 8, 4, 8, we have got the answer. Fine. Then find then. Here also we can see. So now we got P equal to 5, right? So when P equal to 5, 6 into 6 is 36. 36, 6, carry over 3. 6 into 5 is 30. 30 plus 3 is 33. 33, 3 will come here. Okay. And again, 3 will be carry over, right? Then 6 into 8. R already we got 8 here, right? So 6 into 8 is 48. 48 plus 3 is 51. So P is 5, T is 1. So now what number you got here? And I got number is 5136, right? 5136. Okay. So now tell me guys, what values I got here? Okay. So see what values I got here. B equal to 6. I got R equal to 8. B equal to 6. R equal to 8. Then I got P is equal to 5. Then I got T is equal to 1. Okay. Then I got C is equal to 3. Then I got what? What else? देखो B R R लिख दिया मैंने B R S R. We got S is equal to 4. We got S is equal to 4, right? I think that's it, है ना? So this should be enough to solve this set actually, right? Okay. So you can just move in the upper part here now. So now you can get the number by using that formula also. Number is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. ठीक है? Otherwise हम लोग यहाँ भी solve कर सकते हैं. You can just see here. देखो. So अगर हम यहाँ पे देखें, see here guys. Now, yes. So now we have got S 4, replace S with 4, R as 8, right? So R as 8 and R as 8, so 8 minus 8, D will be 0. ठीक है, so D will be 0, so D भी 0 आ गया, fine. Let's move forward now. Okay, E minus S is equal to R, right? What is E guys now? So E minus S is equal to R. Now tell me here, S is equal to 4 and R is equal to 8. So something minus 4 is equal to 8. So I have to have 12 here, right? So for 12 here, E has to be equal to 2. So when E is 2, it will ask for one carry. 12 minus 4 will be 8, right? So I got E equal to 2. So once I got E equal to 2, so after that, what I can do here? Once I got E is equal to 2, so 2 and 2, all we got, right? Yes, yeah, fine. So 2 E equal to 2. So now S was actually 4, and out of 4, E has asked for carry 1. So when S was 4, so S is left now with 3, 3 minus 8. So 3 minus 8 will end up in 5, right? This has end up in 5 actually. So P is actually 5. And now if 3 minus 8 is equal to 5, so now U minus B is giving 0. So B is already 6, right? And U minus B is 0. That means U has given one carry, and after one carry it is becoming 0. U minus B is 0. That means U was initially what? U was initially 7. Okay, so U is 7. So we got all the values, hence this set is solved, right? It's a very good CAT level LRDI set, right? It's a very good CAT level LRDI set. Okay, so we have seen in CAT questions based on crypto arithmetic. Okay, so there's one more video on crypto arithmetic that green filling in my this playlist, right? Okay, so good CAT level LRDI set it was. Okay. So that's it for today, guys. So just let me brief you for 2 minutes. Okay, so just with the change pattern of CAT, don't panic. Okay, don't panic at all. Just focus, stay calm, work hard, right? There's never an alternative to work hard, guys. Okay, so work very hard, study for maximum hours in a day. It could be 8 hours, it could be 10 hours, it could be 12 hours a day, right? All the people who are working, they can plan some leaves now. Okay, if it is LOP, it is fine, right? So just plan some leaves, right? And just work very hard, guys. Okay. Similarly, what I'll actually also tell is there are a lot of LRDI sets, right? So I'm trying to upload few practice sessions, okay? But actually, in Unacademy Plus, we are doing 400 LRDI sets, right? Okay. So out of that, 70, 80 very good LRDI sets are on free, right? So at Unacademy Plus, you can just go to my profile, okay? And in my profile in Unacademy, you can just go to special classes, okay? And under special classes, will find a lot of quant practice, high quality quant practice questions and LRDA practice sets for free, right? Just finish quickly, guys. Okay, 70-80 LRDA sets, if you can do it quickly, okay, then you can actually have a great advantage over others, right? Okay, so just try to finish those 70-80 LRDA sets. It's very high quality, nice LRDA sets, okay, which will be required in this time actually. Okay, so just complete those, and there are very good quant practice sessions also. Okay, so just finish out them, okay? So see you guys in the next video, okay? Bye-bye. Take care, thank you.